It's time we stand up and take over.
Don't be afraid. Don't be ashamed. We want black power. We want black power. We want black power. We want black power. Everybody, what do you want? That's what we're gonna get.
Almost overnight, black power groups were organizing across the country, each with their own idea about what the phrase actually meant.
You had everybody from those that are saying, yes, let's go for elected office, to those that say, let's overthrow the government.
But not everyone was on board with the new slogan.
Now, we don't believe in black power. That's the wrong word. That's a dirty word.
There are certain segments of African American communities that just really believe that black power is disruptive, that it's wrong, that it's violent, and that that is not the way to get ahead in society. And so there are a lot of African Americans who, in fact, denounce black power at its peak.
No matter how endlessly they try to explain it, the term black power means anti-white power. It shall not now poison our forward march.
There was a real fear that the idea of black power, the idea of African Americans challenging white liberals in the Democratic Party, would scare white folk.
The phrase black power gives a wrong connotation, and there are those who associate it with black supremacy, with a call to violence, and with a call to Negro separatism, a feeling that the Negro now feels that he can make it alone.
The day of Martin Luther King's nonviolence has come to an end. I got three witnesses right here in this audience who were there when he said, my day's finished.